Okay, we are going to head off soon. It's 5:27 in the morning AM. I had just under 4 hours sleep. I woke up at 4:15, couldn't get back to sleep. Outside you can see those strange things driving along. I don't know what they're for or what they're doing out there, but they just drive along the beach and that thing, and we're going to be driving out to the airport now. It's quite light outside at this time because it's not daylight savings, so the sun comes up pretty early. Anyway, we're going to leave very soon. The goal is to leave at 5:45, and currently Jazzy is complaining about the milk. Jez, what happened is milk's been put in there, but that particular type of cereal, it sucks up all the milk, it steals from you. So you've had it, you don't want any more of that breakfast. Let's have fun now in Hobart. Let's go. Okay, so we're making sure we've packed everything.
It's not.
We've got the bags.
No, don't bring two, just get your other one.
We're gonna go.
Bend quick.
So we're each carrying one suitcase each.
I'm
carrying this one. This one's, it looks light, it's heavy. He almost forgets his wallet. Oh, and there's these two. There's four bags, we're each carrying one bag.
Someone must
so you're missing your e-tag now.
Where is it?
Well, it's not up there.
Did it fall off?
I don't know.
Did I fall off?
Why are you trying to stuff pillows in bags, Mum?
Because
why are we taking pillows?
We need to take pillows.
So we can sleep there. So we pack our own pillows.
Push it up.
Push it up.
Oh, wait. So we're sleeping there, but we won't have any beds.
Yeah, there's actually, Mum's actually squashed an entire three-piece bed thing into a bag.
Now, what are we going to sleep on the ground bed with a pillow each?
No, the bed, just pop out bed in a bag.
We don't have a bed.
We do have a bed.
So right now it's Sydney, we're still in Sydney. We're all wearing short sleeves and that kind of thing.
I'm not!
For Jazzy, but everyone else is. So let's see if that changes in Hobart. Remember, it is summer now. So let's just see if, you know, the temperature is different. Can we still wear, like summer in Sydney, you walk around sweating to death during summer. Is that going to be the same at Hobart?
Oh, but Sydney's very unpredictable. You can say, oh, there won't be any traffic, go there. There's millions of people from the whole earth. Just
we're currently in Mossman. And we're getting... I film just little minutes every now and then, and we're almost in Sydney.
Uh-huh.
Well, actually, not really. We'll be there.
We're almost in Sydney.
What I meant to say before is we were not in Sydney, as in Sydney City, that thing over there with all those big tall buildings yet. Is that North Sydney or Main Sydney?
Like? CBDs.
But that's the North Sydney.
Oh, that's not even the actual city city. That's just North Sydney. The real Sydney is... like cities down. That's just the like.
Reels.
That's just the fake.
CBD is central business.
Yeah, I know. But that what you see there is just the
fake city.
The not even over the bridge yet in the actual city.
Yeah.
And there's Sydney Tower, which used to be called West Point Tower and then Centrepoint Tower. It's had four different names, that tower, in the last 10 years.
Centrepoint.
Yeah, that's what I used to call it.
What's down on top of the harbour bridge?
Yeah, then it was West Point Tower, and then it was Sydney Tower now.
Classes go.
What's that on top of the harbour bridge?
A crane. But that's not on the harbour bridge, it's on the building over there. Anyway, we're going to go through the tunnel, aren't we? Oh, this is that tunnel. Look it up on the internet. If a big, heavy, like too tall truck tries to grow through this, a water thing comes down and says stop. Like it's an actual stop.
I didn't hear that bloody thing beep, you know? I didn't hear it beep.
It's like a floating imaginary stop sign that appears there and you can drive through it. So cool. Google it. Google Sydney water stop sign. Bad lighting here, but look at those names. Woolamanoo and Wollongong.
Woolamanoo.
Why do we call it Woolamaboo or something?
Woolamoo.
It still sounds funny.
That's
That's how you say
it. I'm trying to say it slowly
so that boy can understand it. What's that strange sign up there?
Strange creature.
It says you've got to go at a variable
speed. What's that unusual white thing moving along the road there?
Dad. Are we actually close to the airport?
Okay, at the moment we are going past the airport. There you can see the planes in there, and it's saying that there's helicopters.
But we need to go to the airport.
Yeah. Well, yeah, but we're going, look, the famous thing, look, here it is. Blue emu. We're coming from the other way this way for good luck. We went the right way last time, but we're coming from the left. Hopefully
we
for good luck.
We didn't come
from,
we came exactly the same way.
Ah, okay, we're going through. There's a plane.
There's a plane that's strange as an airport.
I didn't say it was strange, I said there's a plane.
You obviously said there's a strange plane doing it. It's a plane doing it at the airport.com.
Okay, here we are. The famous, it's now famous from our last video, blue emu. Now let's see. When I see this sign, my goodness, I wish it wasn't so bright, like backlight here. What do you rate blue emu car parking for their service?
One.
Well, since last time they were very, very nice and drove us around helping us find our motor car. They helped us find our motor car.
That's bad. One is bad.
I do like them. I should have said they were bad because they did end up helping us at the end. Now, here's the moment of truth, which I'm sweating about already. So, where do I put this in?
Oh, no. Not again.
I don't know.
Dad reacts to blue.
What's this?
Dad reacts to blue in you.
Pre-booked, pre-scan barcode, it says.
No, but or you can insert your credit card.
Well, I've inserted the credit card already.
Do that barcode. That thing?
Yeah. But that's not a barcode.
Hey, Philip!
Did we get through? Oh, yes, it worked.
Listen.
Yay, we got through.
Can I show you something?
Yeah, what is it?
I had a little activity I always had to do every morning. Now I don't have to do it anymore.
Why don't give it to me? Here.
Oh,
Mom!
So it's now been about 40 minutes and we're still looking for a spot. This blue emu car park is an arm jump on your leg. It's been 5 minutes. We can't find a spot.
There's two spots there at the end of these cars. Look.
Are they really spots?
Are they?
No, they're not spots. Oh, here's a spot here, Doc.
Where? Oh, okay, good. We're near the corner. We can remember we are near a corner.
Well, we're actually right at the edge.
There's a few.
And there's a little Hello Kitty on the chair. Look.
You should have left the window open. Okay, so we're near the corner. We will remember where we are this time, so we don't have to go looking through 6,000 car spots. My gosh, it is packed at the airport. Oh my gosh. It's the worst time of the year to travel. Oh my goodness. Okay, so we're about to take off. Everyone's boarding into the plane. There's outside. We didn't get the seats we booked though, so unfortunately there's a wing there. But if you look up, you don't really notice it.
Your crew members in the cabin today, we have Jason, Ben, Olivia, and once again, my name is Courtney.
As you can see, the flight is extremely delayed. It was supposed to leave like 23 minutes ago. And this plane also has these ridiculous neck-breaking headrests to send everyone to a chiropractor afterwards. Push your head forward. Okay, we're supposed to have left over half an hour ago now, but there's some kind of emergency on the plane, so going to take it longer.
The little things we have to do, so it might be another 5 to 10 minutes before we push back in. Once again, thanks very much for your understanding.
Why are we doing that?
It looks like it's an hour delay this flight so far.
Later than anticipated. So do you want me to give you the number?
So the plane's now an hour and 15 minutes late.
Reservation
still not taken off yet.
While on board this aircraft, it is a requirement for you to follow all illuminated information signs and crew member instructions. It is also recommended that...
fine outside now.
Clouds.
Okay, we are now over the clouds. Damage before we drive it. So we're now absolutely super late to get to the property for the inspection because the plane, as you know, was delayed an hour and 15 minutes because they were fueling in the plane or whatever. And then after they fueled, then we're about to take off, we go onto the taxiway. And then when we're on the taxiway, they then go back and they say, oh, someone's had a medical emergency in the back seat. And then all these, you know, people came to check that guy out in the back, and then they took him off the plane. Then they said, okay, now because we've been on the taxiway for so long, we've now got to refuel the plane because they wasted all that fuel there. And then everyone was waiting, so it ended up being an hour and 15 minutes later that the plane left the airport because of all that.
Okay, 110. Okay,
that's fast.
What's the estimated arrival? Get down the shortest route to...
Okay, so we're going to drive through Hobart and get to the location of the property. Hopefully we make it there on time. Look at how cool that mountain is. It's got a different colour to it.
We can go straight past the queues and go straight through to the waiting lounge because
those trees are there.
Were for just the checking luggage, but we only brought carry on. Yeah. That was lucky.
He's not going at 110.
Give you a call back later and let you know how the inspection went and once settlement has actually...
Okay, we have reached civilization. After a while of driving through nothingness, there are houses over there. So, Mum removed
the headrest. Dad said they're not removable.
Look at how bad that is for your back.
And I pressed one little button.
Ford had a special feature whereby you had to use a pin to remove it, okay?
But if you have an Ford. Phil, you could break your neck.
So I'm surprised it's able to be removed.
Remember they said that there's wildlife on the road.
I saw some more.
The thing is, if you try and avoid them, you'll have the crash. You just have to run them over. As soon as you turn this wheel, you're likely to kill yourself.
At this speed, you really
what happens is the car loses control and you end up killing your whole family. I'm going on 100 because the speed camera's hidden in bushes here. I can't possibly go 110 because I blink and I've just lost 3 or 4 points, okay? Hard to go on 70 on this damn road.
Why is it hard to go 70 on
this road? Because this car just doesn't want to go 70. It just wants to go faster than 70. This is 70.
It wants us to get there.
This is 70. I'm trying to struggle to keep it on 70.
So what's the car doing if you're trying to keep it on 70?
I'm trying to keep it on 70.
But what's the car doing?
While we're going down a hill.
Left, Dad. Left. Left.
Oh, yeah, phew. I almost went down that silly waiting thing.
Continue on Davies Street.
That is such a funny shaped bridge.
Keep going left, Dad.
Keep going left.
Then that's Mount Wellington up there, isn't it?
Of course it is.
I wonder if it's snowing up there today, the top. It's summer, but, you know. And it's actually hot, like, no one's wearing a jumper here in Hobart. You don't need to. Even Dad took his jumper off. Are you wearing warm clothes?
No. What's this bridge called?
I don't know.
Tasman Bridge.
The Tasman Bridge.
You know that.
I didn't know that. And over there is the tallest building in Tasmania. But you can't see it. So out the window, there's a circus.
Trying to
watch
signs and listen to directions. Am I going Moscow. The right way or
yep.
what?
You are.
Can you direct your father?
Yeah, I can see you.
Now it's gone all the way down to 50 now, so I have to go all the way down to 50 now.
Okay.
Or just do 50.
Well, I'm about to do 50.
Saw a circus.
Yeah, I know, we saw the circus.
If that man just didn't have a medical emergency on the plane, if he just...
Now, yeah, but imagine whole families under stress because of that one man.
I know that
a whole family and another 200 people under stress.
Yeah, because of that one man. Couldn't just wait till he gets to 2.1 kilometres.
Turn left onto
Keep going forward
toward Kingston.
No, I missed what you said.
Keep going forward.
Against kids.
That's what I said. Keep going.
No,
forward.
But you spoke and it spoke at the same time.
Yeah. So keep going forward. That was the instruction I gave. They are quite tall, the buildings here.
That's not tall.
But tall to compare to what I'm used to. If it's more than 4 stories, it's considered tall by my standards.
I actually like this car better than the Corolla. It hasn't got a silly transmission in it.
Oh, really? Oh, okay. Yeah. keep going straight ahead for quite a while. So like
this
is
sticking to film.
No, this is stop making fun of me. This is like, you know, CBD ish. It's not exactly, but you're kind of like, this would be the equivalent of driving around Sydney.
Turn left onto Southern Outlet toward Kingston.
So there's like not much traffic. This is good.
Not turning yet, Mitch.
So we're currently driving in, what do you call this? Southern Outlet.
It's just, yeah, it's like a freeway thing down the Kingston, Southern Outlet, yeah. Built in 1985.
It's pretty good because it's better than that, you know, coastal way. You get there faster.
No, I know, if you're in a hurry, you go that way, but I prefer the coastal, but yeah. This is when you hurry, you come down here.
Yeah.
Is this when you're in a hurry?
You come this way, yeah, to get to Kingston.
So as you can see, it's 20 degrees. Well, you can't really see from.
Why are you
it's 20 degrees.
When you get
just
a sore on your
arm. It's okay. It's after a while. So what do you think of this car, the Nissan Pulsar?
It's an okay sort of a car. It's got a better transmission than the Corolla.
Yeah.
I would just say that the...
In 1 kilometre, just left on Southern Outlet toward Third Side.
The steering feels a bit weird, that's all I'd say. The steering's strange.
Okay. Well, how is it different? Did you see that Bruny Island? We're not allowed Bruny Island in this car.
Well, it has to be Corolla, does it?
No, it literally says no Bruny Island trips. You know, they say you're not allowed to go to Bruny Island.
We'll get there if you're not allowed to go there.
No, in this, there's some roadkill. That's what the lady at the thing said. You've got to watch out for wild animals going across the roads.
Our inspection slightly delayed, and they actually said, we thought the settlement wasn't till 2 o'clock anyway. So they're 100% ready to settle.
Mm. Yeah.
And Dion said he'll meet us there. He said he's stuck in traffic in town, but I can't
their know. Idea of traffic here is just ridiculous. I mean, Sydney is traffic.
One car in front of you, that's traffic jam.
We just went through the town and it was fine.
Oh yeah.
So I'm just going to tell Virginia, if she wants to delay it just slightly, we don't mind.
Okay, we're coming down the hill now.
Looking over Kingston.
We are very close to the property now. We're about 10 minutes away. We'll do. Fantastic. Thank you. Bye.
In 4.7 kilometres, the destination is on your left.
I saw a man walking on a roof over there. I thought he was weeing, but he was playing with barbed wire.
I thought you were going to say he's playing with Barbies.
Someone just playing with barbed wire. Suncoast Drive.
Oh, that's
I thought that as well, but I thought it was going
to say Barbie. Now we're getting pretty close.
It's such a dangerous road to walk on when you think
about
it.
Barbara.
Just on your face there and nose and here. Just do that.
Jazzy
please.
Hates getting sunscreen on.
Seriously, take your glasses off. Darling, your glasses won't get
you're on YouTube. Show the YouTubers how you put sunscreen on.
Darling.
Do a sunscreen tutorial.
Just put your glasses, please. Otherwise, you won't be able to explore the grounds and they're beautiful.
You'll have to stay inside the house if you don't want sunscreen.
Okay. So she said
now,
she'll only
give me
put
your
sunscreen
hand
on if we film it.
Leave your glasses here. Put them there so it doesn't...
Quick, do the sunscreen tutorial. Say, okay, today there, guys.
No.
I'm just putting some
this
sunscreen
really
on.
This is really nice sunscreen. Yes, now, what you do is... No, do this. Look, with your hand. And then do this. Look. Especially on your nose, chin, and cheeks. Go all over. And your nose, like this, and here, chin and mouth, rub it in.
There you go.
Keep doing it.
How was that?
Keep doing more. Easy. Let me see your hands. That's good, keep doing more because you want to get it all over your face.
Oh, look at that big mountain there. So that goes up, now that is a mountain. That goes up to 300 meters above sea level.
How come it smells now?
Did you calculate it just then? Using
no.
Your mind?
I've googled it and looked at the Google terrain thing and height maps and stuff.
Wow.
because I was wondering if it would snow there, but generally you don't get snow under 500 metres.
The destination is on your left.
Where's the house?
There it is, over there.
There's
the problem.
There's the young
house.
Now we're in our official...
And in our land.
Both sides.
There's more land there, so that's ours.
Yeah, you own that
both
side.
Both sides.
And
are
you
ours.
Own that side.
Yeah.
So the chicken's gone? Yeah, they're gone.
I can see one little clucker there.
No, they're gone.
Why are they gone?
The chook house.
I can hear something.
It's the lovely birdies.
Oh, there was a bird there, and I missed it. Oh, it was a really cute bird in the tree. We're going to see a lot
they're
of wildlife.
Really cute birds.
Okay.
There's a clothesline.
Where?
There.
Oh yeah, there it is.
The fence to the
That's where you saw the sheep the other day.
Where are sheep?
Like 6 months ago.
I was going to park it in the carport.
I want to go on a sheep hunt. I want to find those sheep.
I'm just going to reverse it.
I'm going to give both our sheep a big pat and a cuddle.
Let's just get
out. No, I'm not.
So I'll come with you. I'll come with you trying to find the sheep.
Is our sheep here? Oh, look at him. He's sitting down.
The other one's here. There they are.
We were just about to go spending ages looking for those sheep.
Can I pat him?
Oh, they were so much more fluffy before.
Can I pat him?
No, because they've been shorn.
Doesn't matter, I can still pat him. He said yes, yes.
That doesn't mean yes.
The sheep are here. Now listen, look, listen to what you can hear.
Yeah, the birds.
It reminds me of how I go to sleep.
Oh, that's a little... Something's around there, my
head. Down there.
Oh, they've been sure. Look how small they look. I wouldn't hang on that fence, darling. It could crush it. It doesn't look very strong.
Yeah, so you come back away from the fence.
So cute. I just want to go down there and feel them.
How do you actually get in there? It's your own bloody property.
We see those trees down there, right down to the gully.
Show him. We own everything you can see around here. Or everything you can see.
He just did a poop.
One day this
look at that mouth, John, on the sideways. Look at that strange creature there, look. But there is a strange creature. Do you know what that strange creature is? I'm scared of that strange creature. How do you get in there? Are we going to the sheep?
No, we won't go. That's one paddock. We own that one. We own that one.
Mm.
That's our
clothesline. I feel like patting the sheep.
Let's go in the main entrance.
Do we actually get into the house?
No. This is the shed. Let me see. Oh, there's the wood cutting machine. This is the wood.
Can't really see in there. So that's our shed. Jazzy's just running off.
Come on, hide!
Where are you going?
No, you go this way, inside here. Yeah, the wood cutting
shed. How do you open this gate? Oh. Simple. Look at these gardens. Grow lots of plants here. There's the house over there.
How do we get to the sheep?
Wait a sec. Look at this. This is cool. Oh, these little cute birds. Oh, they flew off.
You should see all the little
birds. Oh, wait, stop. They're so cute. What do you see?
There's those lovely birds over there
where,
in the grass.
Just go
forward.
Where are they?
Just keep going.
I don't see them. Those, I always see those birds. They're normal.
That's your bedroom in there.
I can't really see it. Can I
still? You can't really see from here.
Don't touch any of the glass. It looks as if they have actually cleaned the glass. This is inside.
Look at that view. Water and mountains.
Oh, look at this tree.
Look at
Don't sit on it.
Wait, what? Oh, it's a wheelbarrow. I thought it was a seat.
See this? You own to the next fence. See where the other house is? That's the other house. See that fence closer to their house?
Yeah.
We own this. This is another paddock.
Oh, so it's lots of land. Not this fence.
Yeah.
It's the one after it.
Yeah, because these fences here just separate the paddocks for the sheep.
Mm. Dad's filming with his iPhone up there. Wait, where'd you go? Just disappeared into a bush. All right. I didn't even know this existed, this bit here. Oh, my shoelace is untied. Oh, there's that icon. What they call it? That lighthouse. Yes, I know that looked fancy, that where that plant just then was in focus, but I was not trying to do that with a blurry background and an in-focus plant. I was trying to zoom into the background.
This is all the property, darling.
Do you like it?
There's lots. You can go out there. That's part of the property.
Not me.
Maybe just me. Ah, Jazz, don't smack your head in. Ugh, couldn't access it from there. Okay, let's go. Are there any of those killer ants in here, though? That's what I'm looking down at, and I'm worried is there.
No.
I just don't want... I know my shoelace has been undone for
this
a long time.
This really needs a
trim. I'm walking through, and you can feel it, like, up your legs, going through the pants, and... This is what you call a lawn, what I had. Remember my Brookvale property? It had, like, a 4x4 metre... lawn that was your backyard, 4 meters by 4 meters.
Dry. That's the only thing, is it's very dry.
It's summer.
They get watered. And that's the master bedroom, and that's the spa room.
It is hot. Like, it's summer and it's hot. It's 20 degrees now. That's what the temperature is. No, but like Hobart.
To go right down to the edge, darling.
My gosh, it kind of just drops off down there, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does.
Okay, where's that icon?
Where's the sheep?
What do you even call that icon?
I don't know. Some
lighthouse. Where's the sheep?
Where's the sheep? The sheep were way away, Jazz. Not over where we are. Where'd that icon go? Do we know that there's no snakes? Because I'm just looking down, I'm worried about snakes, spiders.
No, well, these people lived here all that time and they're elderly.
She's... Ah! There was something on me. Ah! Ah! There's always flying... Ah! Ah! Down. I don't like this. There's flying creatures and they keep flying... Ah!
Edge down there, and that's where you...
Oh, okay, so you go down that winding...
Yeah, not now.
I'm filming you filming me. This Tasmania, people think it's too cold to live in. Look at that. I mean, shorts. Jazzy's just looking for the sheep everywhere. Okay, we're going to come into the property now and see what it's like inside. Oh, your voice echoes in here.
Hi.
Hi. Jazz. So I'm going to look outside, Jazz. You don't want to be saying that on YouTube. Look out there. That. What do you think of the view, Jazzy?
Philip, I heard
How
the
do you?
I heard the bees.
Wait.
Philip, I heard the bees.
There we go. This is outside on the balcony. Now, the thing I like about this balcony is this is a balcony you can sit there, you can put a table out here and you can actually eat. You can't do that where we live because it's so tiny. It's a really thin balcony. Like our balcony, see this? That's like the size of our balcony at our current place. It's that big. Yet, look at this. You've got all this space here to do whatever you like. Let's just take in this landscape for a sec. that's a neighbour over there. You can actually still see the neighbour, so it's not that rural. This is considered semi-rural. Okay. And there's the water out there. And that lighthouse. And the gardens down here. And I'm going inside because it is boiling hot out here. Hobart is not cold.
What?
Where? Where? Oh, crud. Okay, that is the bee that is absolutely terrifying us right now. It tried to attack me on my way into this property. There's keys here. Oh look, there's a bathroom. On this part of the house. Oh, look out there, you can just see flowers outside. This feels a bit small, this room though, to be honest. The room's not as big as I thought. It's a shame that it's wooden floor though. Oh yeah, this is my room. Oh, this is a big room. Yes! Carpet! It's a carpet room. That's what's outside my window.
I'll be upstairs. My room's going to be upstairs.
We are upstairs. Do you want to go downstairs?
No, I'm going up.
So that's where my computer can go. You couldn't do a 3-screen setup there. For my screen size, 32-inch, but you could definitely fit one or two 32-inch screens there, but I'm fine with one. I'm not like a multi-monitor person. I only ever like one screen. Okay, walking slow. Oh, this is a cool room, and look, that's a real fireplace, Jazzy. You know how we've got a fake fireplace at home? That's a real one. You put real wood there and burn it.
Oh. Come on. Oh, what's this?
So you finally have an upstairs and a downstairs. The four-bedroom house.
I guess this one's going to be my room.
No, I think this is Mum and Dad's room. Or a lounge room, I don't know. Could be either.
I'm scratching.
Well, don't scratch.
Itchy.
Well, don't be itchy.
Cool. Now let's come up. Let's scroll downstairs.
It's a cupboard there.
Oh, I found Dad.
I found Dad. You actually have to find him. That's a spa.
This is one of the spas.
No, there's one.
Can I tell you something? This is good for playing hide and seek around this.
Mm-hmm. Do a lot of hide and seek in here.
There's an icon. Look, there it is.
Everyone's like, the icon. It's the lighthouse.
So can we actually play hide and seek now?
No, we're not playing hide and seek. We're looking at... There's a shower. What is this room?
It's supposed to be a walk-in wardrobe, but it's...
It could be like another bedroom.
It's actually big enough to be another little room. I'm thinking just putting a desk and some books and my cards in this room and wardrobe, build a wardrobe somewhere else, or I don't know, in the other room. Plenty of room here.
Lot of people living on the mountain today. What's that?
That's your new bedroom.
No.
See?
It's more like a coffin.
It's spacious, isn't it?
Storage.
Oh, look at that. It's actually...
What?
Oh, I thought that was fake brick. It's real brick.
No. Okay. Well, we've seen the house, Jazzy. What do you think of it?
I need the wardrobe.
This is a good place for hiding, you know, and see.
when the UV rating goes down, I'm determined before we go home, I want to pat our sheep because they're so cute, but they're more cute when they're fluffy. Jazzy, what's the problem?
No, that's not your room, that's the spare room,
Jesse.
Your
room. It's this room. It's so small, look, that's small.
It's still bigger.
It's small. See, I've got really
You got your bed here.
Jesse, now you've got loads of room, you don't have to worry about it. You've got, look, your bed will go here,
no.
And you've got the whole room
here. No,
Jesse, you can't be nasty.
Where'd Jesse go? On your own there. Hello. Okay. So Jazzy, what are we gonna play now in our place? Hide and seek. Okay, so go hide and I'll try and find you. I'm covering my eyes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, I'm gonna try and find you. Where did Jazzy go? Oh, I heard some noises down here. Downstairs. Where could have she have gone? Is she in this weird thingy, my Bobby? Oh my gosh, she actually is! I was just joking. Jazz, get out of there.
Hey, that was a
door. I was joking. I wasn't actually going to look in there. I was just pretending I was like as if she would go in there. But you actually did end up going in there. I thought you were going to hide in, like, in this cupboard in here. That's where I thought you were actually going to hide.
I was actually going to hide in there, but yeah. I didn't.
Okay, hide one more time. I'll look out here while I count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, coming, ready or not? I heard sounds up here. I'm looking for Jazzy. We're playing hide and seek.
That's the size of a double bed. You'll have a double bed. That's the size of double bed, but I would put it here. I would have it coming to there so that when you walk into the room, that way the sun won't go on your face or anything.
Yeah, I see. That's a good idea.
I'd have it this way.
On that side instead. How do you get rid of those?
Oh, that comes up. That comes up over time.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's just...
Okay, I'm going to find Jazzy now because she's hiding. Not in there. Is she in this room somewhere?
Did you see these?
Wait a sec. Not in there. Where could have she gone? Oh, and that's thingy.
The Venetians,
yeah. I'm just going to try and find... where that jazz pot has gone. She's not in here. What about this one? Oh my gosh! Jazzy, stay there. I want Mum to see. I was not expecting that.
Jazzy! Get out! Get out! Careful.
That is not the... You wouldn't expect that. That's a thing. You wouldn't expect that.
Do you actually like the house or not? Seriously? Yeah. You sure you like
it? Yeah. It's very 70s, but as I said,
No, but we modernise. Yeah, that's changing.
Yeah, but I don't care about that. 70s, 1940s, 1800s, I'm okay with it. Okay, I'm just looking at the bathroom.
Have you seen the bathroom up here?
No, I haven't.
Well, that's yours.
Oh, well, I have, but I forgot to say that I had.
What do you think of this bathroom?
There's a...
Fella, let's play again.
Okay, one more time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
It's got a tastic
everywhere. I hate that word tastic. Just say fantastic.
Toilets here. And look at the laundry.
Yep. Okay, I'm gonna find Jazz. Coming, ready or not? Obviously, she's hiding down here somewhere. Unless she's around this corner. No. Actually fun. In our place, hide and seek is not very exciting because it's a tiny little 3-bedroom unit. But in this place, it's It's kind of cool. Wait, I think I heard a jazz noise. No, she's not in here. Oh, where did Jazzy go? Jazz! Oh, she actually has me stumped now. I actually don't know where Jazzy is. There you are. Okay, you keep it closed and I'm gonna hide now and you're gonna try and find me. Count to ten.
One.
Just a clue, I'm downstairs. You found me. Was that fun?
Yeah.
Okay, well that was our hide and seek for the day. Now we're probably gonna have to go and find a place to get lunch in Kingston. Say that again, what would you have off? This. What's the point of it anyway?
Oh, this is... Another apple tree. Look, that's another little apple tree.
Is it an apple tree?
It's a little mini apple tree.
How do you know what a little mini apple tree looks like?
Yeah, they're small. They haven't grown yet.
Are they like baby animals?
I don't know if they're apples. Look at those strange flowers.
Away from here, there's bees. There's bees. There's bees. Yeah. Oh yeah. We'll play hide and seek. I just want to see if I can see the sheep.
Hey, do you want to go for a little walk down to those? Oh, there's a bird!
Where?
A bird?
Do you know what
where?
It's doing?
Where?
Window. See your look at the flickering there.
Oh, it's yeah, he's looking in your at himself in the mirror.
Mirror.
Yeah.
He's yeah. flickering inside
he's
the
excited.
Mirror. Look.
See, oh yeah, in the car.
Bird seeing the mirror and having a fit there. Look.
Zoom in.
Yeah,
I
did.
That's a cute little finchy top. Look, this Willy Wag. Yeah. How many cars could you fit here?
You can actually fit two cars in here. Easily.
Double car park.
Yeah.
And they said it was a single.
Did they?
You can fit two in.
Is this like the size of our garage, literally?
I think it's...
Our double garage?
What's the shed here?
What?
Oh, that's where the wood is stored for the fireplaces.
Let's go find the sheep. I want to find the sheep. I'll get my shoes on and I'm going to go and I'm going to find those sheep. Diana's trying to get rid of a blowfly.
Gone.
How did you... You just grabbed it with your hand.
Yeah, I'll wash my hands
down. What is it?
Okay, we are now... We're going to find those sheep because that's what I want to do. Where are they? Let's go, Jazz.
The bag's in and Jazzy's taking out the pillows that we've crushed.
Squashed. Wait, did that bag fit two pillows in it?
Yes, it did. Squashed up.
Yikes.
And those pillows will get really big now and puffy. We're going to put...
And when are we going to Kingston for some lunch?
I might put these back.
Tonight.
No, not tonight. I want to go...
So here are the pillows.
We ate at 6 something a.m. and it's now after midday. All you can hear is birds out here. Listen to this. Birds everywhere. Bird in the tree and I want to catch this bird. Not catch him, but like catch him on camera. Oh, it's over there. Look at him, that tiny one with the blue on him. Wow. Look at him with his tail. That is so, oh, look at how cute he is. Oh, where did he go? Oh, where did those sheep go? They're the ones I want to see right now. They're supposed to be somewhere in here. They've probably walked down and hidden somewhere. Look who I found. I found one of the sheep. I want to give him a pat. I don't know how you get a... I'll try and go through that gate. Right now I'm on my way to the sheep, but I'm dodging all the sheep poo. Okay. Look at this sheep. There's two of them. I want to give them a pat. Oh, he's gotten up. It must be hot for these sheep because they're not used to this. Come on. Oh, they're walking away. Where are they going? Oh, the sheep have run away from me. I need sheep training. They just keep walking and pooing. Guys, I wanted to have a talk to you. Well, there they go. Well, I'll see them later.
Obviously not right.
That fell off the tree.
To me, it looks like an apple.
So, is it an apple or a peach?
Can't you see how it's got that strange little imprint on the middle? That's a peach.
Oh, yeah, look at that. There. Apples don't have that.
Apples don't have
that. So, we don't know if that's an apple or a peach.
It's an apple. I mean, it's a peach. Even I'm confused.
What do we do with our peach apple?
Oh, just chuck it back in the garden.
Give it to me. I'll put it back in the garden for the animals. Oh, we should keep it as... Oh, no, we can't.
A souvenir.
They get pulled over at the airport.
We could have made a dinner with it.
Fresh food and veggies.
We could have made a dinner with it.
You are a dinner. Okay, let's go. So, where are we going for lunch?
Don't know. Wherever your mum says to go.
You said rehab kebab.
That's where I'd like to go, yeah.
As we drive out of here, let's have a look at those sheep that ran away from me. I tried to pat them, but they just don't want a pat. Where are those sheep? There they are.
No, that looks like a worker. They're doing work.
Oh, look at our sheep. Hello, sheep. Hello.
Just looking at us.
Hello, sheep.
Our head is turned backwards to get us good shot.
And there's the other one. Get up. Every like 5 steps they take a poo comes out.
That's how they power their way through the dark.
Listen, that poo fertilizes the ground and it's poo that if you step on your it doesn't go in your shoes. It's okay. Pellets.
What did you find? A chicken?
It's a chicken.
Oh yeah, it's running.
There it is. Look at it.
It's up there.
Oh, it's gotten out. It's a chicken.
It's escaped from somebody's yard.
Oh shit, there's a snake! There's a snake!
There is a snake.
Oh my gosh! Binge! Binge! Binge!
Where?
There's is that the snake? Snake? Yep.
Where? Where?
Yeah, I can see it just slithering through. There is snake. That's what you're gonna have in the wild.
Is it on,
could be on either side
branch?
Of us. No, it was slithering along the ground and there was a chicken there too.
Where is it?
The snake wouldn't get the chicken, would it? Do snakes
where
eat chicken?
Is it?
Can you see it?
No.
It's got up that way.
Can you see it?
It's up there. On I can chicken. See it. Yeah, the chicken's the up chicken. There. And the first thing we could smell in Kingston is a bushfire. A
friendly local fireman will put it out shortly.
And there's Mount Wellington in the distance. Whoa. Now, something interesting to
that's
notice.
It's a huge mountain.
Here, the sun in Hobart, the day is from... sun rises at 5:58 a.m. and the sun sets at 8:52 p.m. Now look at where, you know, where we're from. The sun rises at 5:50 a.m. The sun sets at 8:09 p.m. And this is summer, so the days are very long right now. But it just goes to show that down here, because we're lower in the earth, you get longer days during the summer and even shorter days during the winter.
Wrist in the distance there,
no, that's
my friend.
Mount Everest.
Isn't it?
You're on Big Hole.
Who's taken Mount Everest then? Where's it gone?
6 weeks.
Are we actually, this is Kingston, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay. But not the, you know...
No, this is just... Oh, actually, it could be Blackman Bay.
Blackman's Bay.
Men's
men's.
I really want to see snow. I wonder if it's snowing.
Yeah, it
there.
Is snowing now. We'll go and grab it. And grab a little packet of it and
grab
take
a
it
piece
home.
Of snow. I want to take it
yeah,
home.
Yeah, it's just there. I can see it.
Put
I'm
it in the freezer.
I put it on hand at the window.
Forever.
I've caught the snow. I'll tell you.
It is. I think at the very tip, I saw a bit
okay.
of snow.
What I do, I'll drop you the bottom
it's
of
summer,
the...
summer. And it's hot out there. Diana, even, who's a cold person, says she's hot.
I'm not hot. I'm comfortable.
I can drop Philip at the bottom of that mountain. He can walk up. It'll take about 2 months and grab a bit of snow and come back down again.
Look, see at the very top. See how
no,
you can see
clouds.
The
clouds.
No, 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 no. Above that, you can see white.
Just a madman bike motorcycle.
The bike
club.
Gang.
Yeah, the bike gang.
Look at that fire on the whatchamacallit.
Yeah, his bike's
the
on
bum
fire.
Thing.
But he has an accident.
I don't know what you call it. Where you sit.
That's commonly known as a seat in the modern English
There's
world.
Videos on YouTube of actual people, bikers running away from Tasmanian police here.
Is there?
I wonder if those were the guys that did it.
So we just want to grab
so
kebab.
So where are the shops? Coles is over there.
Yummy kebab, huh?
There's a radiology there. Radiology Tasmania.
Do
so where are we
just
going?
Park, walk around or
Rehab Kebab, there's is that the place you want to go to?
Yeah.
They've got Big W here too, and Toyota.
Out the back.
We're just getting out now and we can see a dog in the car.
You got my purse? I told you to get it.
Look at him.
So cute.
What are
you doing?
It's
cute.
Cute.
What is that?
He likes me because I pat him and then I walk away and then he goes... He wants me.
It's a Spartan lamb kebab.
We saved some money by going to get dessert at Coles with their specials. Those would cost you like $3 each, those in a shop, wouldn't they?
Mm-hmm.
Cost us a dollar each at Coles.
Yeah. Only because it was half price.
Do you find the specials are good here to compare to Sydney Coles?
Oh, it's got good specials, but very similar to Sydney.
Okay. Okay, after having lunch and visiting Coles, we're on our way back home. Well, home for one day anyway. It looks like that gold horse is a strange creature.
They're so strange.
There were some strange creatures. There were humans in there, but there were some strange creatures as well.
The beachfront?
Yeah.
You can't live on the beachfront.
Is it a chair and table?
What would it be?
Very small.
What would it be just
maybe
slotted
it's for
over
the animals.
Oh, I know. It's for an animal to sit down and have a meal at night.
Okay, well, we're back.
Shed.
Well, the thing is with the shed, we
there's
have
stuff
to move
in the
shed.
Mower
into the shed.
Yeah, because we own the shed. They've left something. I own it now.
Why are you going here?
Because I'm going to
we're
reverse
have a break
in the carport.
And...
Jesse,
charge the camera up. It's currently 3:23.
I didn't bang into anything.
So we're going to charge everything up.
What do I deliberately bang into something for?
Well, there are our sheep.
So there's our shoes, okay?
Okay, they're there at the door. So that is such an old-fashioned key.
I like it. It's like you're going back in time.
Mom, can you take your shoes off?
Can I see that key? Can you show it to me?
Yeah, look.
Show me the key. What's the key?
1872 key.
Oh my gosh, it looks so old-fashioned.
1872.
We're used to the, you just put something up to the door, we just go beep, and then we get let in. Look at this here. This is the orange juice we bought. You can know we're in Tasmania because it's saying like 100% Tasmanian owned. Look at this, it's saying save the Tasmanian devil. It's really, it's funny to be in Tasmania.
Yeah, that's nice.
Can someone pour me some orange juice?
So there seems to be a little bird. It's one of those bluebird things.
You go forward.
Go, go!
Okay, shh.
So what have you made, Jazzy?
A bed for us to watch
So we're going to watch a movie off an Alienware laptop and that's where we're going to sleep because we don't really have a bed in this place. So we sleep on the floor. Okay, we're going to go explore now. I want to pat those sheep. We've been calling them for ages.
So in the future...
Look at all the keys. See, they're all old-fashioned keys. What are these, like, 70s keys?
1970s, yeah. They're from the 70s, those keys. Mm-hmm. That's a modern key there. That's
why did they make these keys? Was this the 90s?
These are more modern keys. They're for...
But why did they make those? What made them choose those over these?
They're more higher security than those ones. They're very easy to pick here. Easy to pick. You can just use like a little pin and push all the little things up and
we'd
break in.
We'd better change everything.
Pushing this one down so it doesn't
Oh, look at this, place, it just looks so full already. Look at this, got stuff all over this kitchen. We're not moving in, we're just here for a day.
Taking the longest,
he
has to pluck my hair.
Okay. You always find him going on that car.
No, blue wrens scientifically proven to know and to love a Nissan Pulsar.
Watch this. But then as soon as you go onto this side of the Nissan Pulsar ST.
Because they think you're a Corolla owner.
That's why. But don't go fast, it's
slow. Okay, so where are we going to go and explore?
Down to our water's edge.
Okay.
And I say our water.
So this way?
No, you want the sheep.
We'll do the sheep next. Yeah, what are they for? Wonder if they're from the 1970s, like most of this stuff from our house.
I think they're in the other
that
one.
Tree stump there is probably to put the clothes basket while you put the clothes on the line.
You stand here and then you get hit. Okay, come on. Jazz, where are you going? Well, I'm trying to not step on poo. Look on the ground, Jesse. Watch out. There's poo everywhere. Look, you look on the ground. Poo. Keep walking. Crushed poo. Poo, 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 poo. It's everywhere. Drives me nuts. But I do want to pet those sheep. Where? Ah, there they are. I like how there's always one head looking at you. They're eating and looking at you. Yeah, there's poo all over the ground. You look down and you see like big poos everywhere. So that's why you gotta watch every step you take, you watch in the paddocks. I really wanna give it a pat.
Yes.
Yay! I patted a sheep! Hi! Yay! Hello!
Yeah, but this one is we're patting a sheep!
I'm patting it! It's so cute! Why doesn't he like your hat? Dad, did you see me patting the sheep?
The grass is a lot greener on here.
The grass is greener on the other side.
Dad, it's much more greener here, fresh friend.
Mum, be careful of snakes.
Yeah, I am worried about snakes. G'day and welcome to Let's Explore episode 1 of Tasmania season 2. No, just joking, we're not doing that yet. One more year. No, Dad, don't do stupid laughs.
Show me a bit of fluff, a bit of respect.
You can hear the frogs in here.
What?
You can hear the frogs.
Oh wait, is this the dam here?
Yeah, this is the
Oh, dam!
And there's frogs.
I hope I don't fall in that dam. Oh no, Jazzy!
Look at them. They're running for their lives. Charging down the field. Hey,
Jazz, stop chasing the sheep. I just walked up to it and went like this, and then he came, and he walked away from Jazzy, then he came to me and I patted him.
Was it, what did he feel like?
He was soft.
Like wool?
Like, you know when you go into someone's house and then they've got a toilet, and in front of the toilet they've got like a soft thing? You touch their soft thing and, yeah, that's what it's like. What is that?
What is that?
A chicken.
What is that chicken?
He's what? Running. Oh my gosh, he's fast.
Oh my god!
Oh, that was so funny! He's just like, yeah, I'll just hang out here. I really want to see a frog.
That same chicken,
he's on our land now. We own him now. Oh, till he runs off. G'day and welcome to another episode of Farm First Timer. In this episode, Dinah is going to be trying out frog catching. So go catch a frog from that lake thing. Damn.
I'm not French.
What?
I'm not French.
Welcome to Farm First Timer. Diana, can you go please shear one of those sheep down there?
Where are the sheep?
I don't know. We'll have to go find them.
So much land, isn't it?
Yeah, there's a ton of land. Oh, Jenny's chased the sheep all the way down there. Do you find this hot? Are you hot? I'm boiling.
It's warm, yeah.
Can you see that icon? Stop with that icon. Referring to the lighthouse, which
Jazzy,
is like some...
can you come back?
Jazz!
We better go.
As you can see, Jasmine is patting a sheep. In 7-year-old tries to pat a sheep. On Farm First Timer, Episode 3. Stop chasing them, we want them to be tame. Well, that's what you get. Yay, you're patting it. Yeah. She's actually patting them.
Bumshong's really good one.
Oh, you feel so good. Oh. You feel so soft.
You feel its air that it's breathing.
Yeah.
Isn't that
funny?
Hello.
Oh. That one's not very good. That one's the only one that's good is the one with the bumshong.
Come on.
You might be so annoying.
Okay, let's go explore our land down now. Did he just do a poo and then kick his own poo?
I don't know. Come on. Ew, I saw the poo rolling.
I saw the poo rolling. Hell of a poo.
Come on, sheep. Come on.
I think that's enough. Mum, if they get to...
eat straw?
They kick their back legs at you.
When did he do that?
No, they can.
Oh, not
when they get angry. But you don't just say not these ones.
Leave him, Jazzy.
Yeah, that's enough now. Is this all our land down here too?
Yes. See that gully of trees?
Okay, let's go.
All the gully right up to almost the neighbours next
door. Go and hope that there's no snakes.
Come on!
Jeez.
What? Oh, did you meet them?
Patrick, the neighbour.
Oh, okay.
He's up there. Having a good old chat.
It's really scary, that
snake. Oh, did you have a good chat?
Yeah, it's Patrick.
Oh, wait a sec.
He owns that vineyard.
Did you tell him that we're all here?
Yeah, I said we're.
Thanks for tuning back in to Wilderness Wanderer, Episode 1. Wow, that seems stupid. You can't tune back into Episode 1. Oh, because you can't tune back in because you'd never tuned in the first place. Like, you have to have, it would have to have at least been Episode 2. In this series, we're going to wander the wilderness in search of some snakes. See? That's where I'm worried that there would be some snakes down there. No running. Wait, do you go down that way or down this way? Is that ours too?
We own right.
But do we own that too?
To the top there.
Yeah, but what's this?
That's all ours.
You own that tree.
No.
I
can't. We've just made it down to the like main part of the hill. I'm not really sure where you go next though. Where do you go down here?
Go up.
No, you don't go up. You'd go down, but this is really thin and narrow.
Oh,
come on, let's go.
What?
You're so slow. It's hot here, still. It's like 5 o'clock now and it's still, I'm not cold. Tasmania is habitable, even in shorts and t-shirt. I'm watching you, watching me, watching you, watching me. Come on, you don't have to be upset. We're just going down a steep gully here. Don't walk, just this fillet. I wonder if we've got any crabs or anything down here. The boat's out there. Imagine going for a boat ride out here. And you could go that way and get to like Bruny Island, which is over there somewhere, around the corner. Okay, we've explored down here. Here we have.
We've been here for like 1 minute. And
Jesse,
you
just stop.
I want to come down and have a look. Come all this way.
Sit down there, sit there. Sit there.
There's that. Oh, Dad! There's that icon! That icon over there.
Wow,
look at that icon. Oh, it is slippery, Jazz. Well, Jazzy's totally beating me around the corner. Hobart summers are too hot. I just can't stand summer. I hate summer. I've just found a weird creature outside our place. Look.
Oh, that?
Yeah.
I thought you meant that dead one.
No, that alive one.
Strange creature.
It actually is weird. We're actually, the reason me and Jazzy are out here is we wanted to get back. We've had enough of exploring, to be honest. But we don't know where the key is. Apparently Dad hid the keys somewhere and he said something about the car. And then that's all I heard. There it is with its funny little tail.
Oh yeah, on that piece of wood.
Such a cool little bird.
Underneath a square rock near the car.
Yeah, I've been looking near the car. I've walked around the car. I'm walking.
Can you see a square rock?
Let me see. I actually didn't hear what you said. I just heard the car, two things. I've walked around the entire car. That's not near the car. Near the car is within this containment.
There's a square rock, look. A square rock near
the car. That is far away. That's not near the car.
That is near the car.
Near the car is within a metre of the car.
Still near the car.
We'll get it.
Pellets in the garage. So we can...
I just want to go inside, to be honest. So what happened
Yeah. Dad went around to the other side of the rock. He found a cave that goes straight through the rock to the other side.
Is
an actual cave.
Is it like Queenscliff Beach Cave?
I think similar to that. It goes right through to the other side.
Okay. Thank goodness inside.
Yeah, I think Dad knows.
Before we start
you give it to them.
I've got to find.
how I'm going to get to them. Hello, sheep. Look what I've got. Come on,
soap to clean your hands with.
Look, it's only lanolin.
Look, what lanolin?
Look at this.
See, in other words, you got no soap.
Look at this.
You probably think he's been having some bit of action from the other side of
it. Look.
He thinks you're entertaining
look
him.
Look at this. Is that good? It was.
He was waiting for the finale. No, I'm not feeding them.
Bring that bag to me. I want it here with me.
You love that.
No, don't let them put their heads in it.
I want to see them put their heads in it.
Wait, just wait. Okay. Now, just wait.
You're like dogs. What?
Just calm down. Come here, look.
go. My sheep.
I want to give it to me.
There you go.
Ow.
What did you do?
I'm sick of falling into that bloody
Jessie,
thing.
Get away from that gully.
Oh, is that good?
Ow. I'm sick of it. Look.
Oh, okay.
You're stuck in here. Please. Just. Oh.
You had his foot up.
Excuse me.
Don't
put your feet up. Just be patient, please. Hey, excuse me. Wait.
Are they only supposed to have a limited amount of this?
I don't know. Okay, wait. Just wait. Okay, there's another one.
I don't have anything.
There you go. Good sheep. Good sheep. I know, when we get inside...
Like gully. Look at that gully.
Oh, you found another one there.
Oh, shit!
Wait.
No.
Excuse me. Excuse me. There you go. You funny thing.
Yeah, I didn't think you'd actually be able to pat them. It's funny that you can actually pat them.
Here.
Ah!
Fluffy thing.
Hello.
That's scary.
Hello. How does he know that that's food, though? I don't understand. How do they... I put the camera up and they don't eat that. How do you know that the camera's not food?
Here you go, look.
I can't eat anymore. It's in the bag. What if we run out of that stuff? Where do we get this stuff? The sheep
lover. We have to buy it. I think they might have taken off.
Okay.
This one's eating me.
That one was even trying to scratch it.
I like how he put his foot up and was trying to get more.
Have you had
It's okay, I was just going to pat you. It's okay. Pat. There you go.
Give him one more little bit.
Okay.
Oh, this looks so good. And let him have it. No, that's all right.
He's stabbed, I'm going. He's like, nah. What you just did before was enough, so he wants me gone.
It's a little after 8 o'clock now. As you can see, because it's Hobart and it's summertime and the days here are insanely long, I mean, it's 9 o'clock and it'll still be quite light outside. You can actually see, you can still see outside, and it's like 8:30 now, so, oh look, there's that icon, it's just a joke we have now, we say, oh look, there's that icon, oh. I don't even know what you call that thing, I should Google it, that lighthouse, so we can find out what it actually is called, but yeah, we can pretty much go outside in a few moments. It is starting to get a little bit cool outside. I mean...
It's 18 degrees right now.
Yeah, 18 degrees. But we're going to go out and we're going to explore the perimeter of the property. I'll see you then. Okay, we are going out. And that key is annoying to use. I don't like 1970s keys. Oh. It's not as cold out here as I thought it would be.
But I'd like to go right around this perimeter. Well,
let's go around the perimeter. Let's start up there and... skittle around.
Okay, only because I haven't really
looked
around the edge.
Okay, well, let's go.
It's a bit cold. Do you want this to
jump? No.
Oh, beautiful roses. Look at that.
Mom, I just want to change this. I don't want to change this rock.
But there's lots of roses.
I don't want to change this rock.
I love that plant. Oh,
that plant's lovely.
Lovely plants.
That's why we should own it. There's lavender.
Is that actual lavender?
Yeah, that's lavender.
Doesn't smell like it.
French lavender, Italian lavender, and there's all... I'd see, look, those are two different lavender plants. Let's have a quick look in here.
Do you know what's going to be weird about this property? Imagine at night time, like, looking out the windows and, you know... That is scary. That moves.
Look where these roses are. Seriously, look. Oh, look at that. Bill. Oh, wow. Just look how gorgeous these roses are.
No, you don't rip off a rose.
Look. How did it get through here?
What do you mean?
Look, the rose got through there.
Yeah. Just a little root needed to go through and then it got big.
Are they strawberries?
What? Where?
Oh my god.
We just bought raspberries.
Oh my gosh.
No, 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 don't just pick them and eat them. Stop, stop. You can't just pick and eat them.
Oh my god, they're raspberries.
But we're not professionals. You stop eating them. But we're not professionals. You don't know they might be. They remember they need to be treated with pesticide. They need to be treated.
Oh my gosh.
Stop just eating the trees.
They're raspberry. They're homegrown raspberries. And I was going to buy some today in Coles. But look at that. Just seriously, look at that.
Yeah, but it's got to be treated. We're not professionals.
Don't treat them.
They all have to be treated and...
pick them and eat them.
Yeah, why does that one look dark, though? Is that an evil one or has it got some disease?
No, not at all. It's just that that one had fallen off, so I'll leave that. But look.
It's chucked it on the ground.
That is a picked I've never picked a raspberry. Oh, my God. Go, put the camera down. Go and get your father. I'm too excited. I have to show him. Quickly. Look, eat it now.
No.
Please. No. It's good.
You eat it.
No, don't pick any more. We want your father. Go and get your father. Seriously. This is just... amazing.
Okay.
Jesse, call your father and say it's an emergency. He has to come straight away.
He'll get
it's the only way to get him to come.
Actually, I wanna come home and see what his reaction is.
Dad! Dad! We need you. Dad! 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 It's amazing!
What?
Come.
What?
It's an emergency.
Come.
I've got to put shoes on, that's going to take time.
Mum's really excited. Do you know what she's found?
A rabbit?
Raspberry tree, and she's picking raspberries and eating them.
Really?
Yep, she's just going from tree to tree eating all these raspberries.
Putting his shoes on, he's going to be a while.
This is amazing. I've never seen a raspberry tree. I've only bought raspberries from Coles. I wouldn't know what the trees look like, let alone picked one off the tree.
But how do you know if they've got infections and stuff?
They don't.
What? What?
Because this is an enclosed, this is a vegetable patch. This is where all the fruit trees, look, peaches and stuff. Look, parsley, Phil. Parsley. Look, you eat that. That's parsley.
You eat that. Okay. Don't mind if I do.
Oh, look at this. This is some sort of Chinese lettuce. Or
Chinese lettuce.
Or rhubarb. It could be rhubarb, actually.
Chinese lettuce.
Look. What? That one's almost ready. Oh, this is amazing. Look at these trees full of fruit. Oh, you know what's over here?
What?
Come over here.
Fluffy little. Phil, it's fluffy.
Yeah, why are a lot of them on the ground?
Phil, it's fluffy.
Look, Phil, rocket. Yeah.
It's like a bomb.
Oh, what, a rocket? Where?
Rocket lettuce.
Oh, just rocket lettuce.
Rocket lettuce. This is pumpkin, I think. This is a pumpkin plant.
How do you know?
These flowers turn into pumpkin.
Those flowers? What?
Flowers eventually turn into pumpkins.
Flowers turn into pumpkins. Oh, okay.
This is amazing. I've got to go back. Is your father here? Oh, this is all raspberry. Watch this. Come here. Look.
Raspberry.
Eat it! It's delicious!
Is it?
Look!
Look, raspberry!
Raspberries!
Oh, wow!
Look!
It doesn't look like there's many on there.
Look, Ben, come here!
Because she's been eating them all.
Look, Ben,
there's one.
Ben, look,
is that
you
ready?
Pull it.
Mum, eat it!
Oh, there's a bunch over here.
Mum!
Ben, look!
Oh, there's a bunch.
I'm getting them, I've got them here, I'm eating them.
Oh, look,
eat this one!
Can't get fresher than that, can you?
Do you know, Phil, this is organic. This is natural. No pesticides, no nothing. Just and nothing can get to
I'm
it.
I'm scared.
That's what, just seriously.
I'm having one.
Oh, Jersey, you're trying.
So if I get a little bit sick, I know you guys will get very sick.
You won't get sick. This is natural. Sure, this is better than the shops. Shops have pesticides. Look.
Aren't you having them?
Oh.
No, that's enough for me.
Just have this one. Seriously.
I'm not a raspberry fan.
Just have it.
Just happened. Humour me.
So good. Mm-hmm. Look at that.
You sure?
I'm positive, Phil. Oh my God. And we were going to buy raspberries today.
Mmm, they're so good.
That's it for me.
I just can't believe this.
Mmm, let me try.
Jessie, please eat it. It's delicious.
Oh, this, look, this is strawberries here. Look, you can tell by the leaves.
Oh, these are strawberries.
There's a strawberry over there.
Oh, there is. There's a strawberry.
Oh, I was actually joking. I was joking.
Look.
A young strawberry just been born.
Strawberry. Oh, my gosh.
And it's just been born.
Let me see.
It's so made for a strawberry.
No, but aren't you supposed to treat them all?
No.
I don't agree
that
with this.
That is delicious.
Can
I just say... Is that another one? That is so delicious. Stop. I'm having a fit over the strawberries.
What are these beasts in the tree here?
What?
Oh, I found another one. Oh! Look. Oh, my gosh.
You're going to... you're not supposed
to
step on them.
Gosh, Phil!
There's lots of these fruit on the ground.
Can I?
Yeah, I know.
Say,
Phil,
they just fall down.
You have never.
No, I do not. I have never tasted, and I never want to taste.
Bite? Isn't it just delicious? That is so. You know, can I just say that's all get? That's better.
Yeah.
That's
more. You eat the rest.
It's more healthy for you than the shops because this is organic.
That's it.
Look at that little strawberry. That grew in our garden. Look.
Yeah, but we didn't grow it. We just walked in and it was already there.
Mum been working for monks. For monks.
Oh my god, that is so good.
But how long does it take for a single strawberry to grow?
Jeez, have you ever tasted? Please have the rest.
No, I don't want any more. Really,
that
I don't want any more.
That flavour is so much better than you can get in the shop.
Okay.
That is, I've never tasted strawberry
is
that good.
Is that why you want to leave you?
We can have 10 pot plants at home in our current place and have strawberries, raspberries, apples.
Oh my god, this is so good.
This is going around eating bits of trees.
Well, otherwise the birds can't get to them.
The birds can't get to them. That's why they're still here. All right.
Oh, that's what these nets are for.
No.
What happened to exploring the perimeter?
We
got a few steps.
We're eating the middle, then exploring.
Look at that. We're supposed to let's explore of the whole perimeter. And look, that's how far we got.
We're eating the middle, then
we're eating our way out to the border.
Okay, this is so good.
You guys have fun eating the trees.
Oh gosh, this is so good.
Beautiful.
This is the reason I don't like organic stuff. Look at those.
No. It's a bit of extra protein.
Yeah.
Nothing like a spider.
Seriously.
On top of a bloody raspberry.
Can we just go? I've had enough of these. You've got a mosquito on your arm.
Come on, let's go.
Let's go.
Yeah.
I'm going to run out of recording space. I've got 15 minutes left.
Oh, wait. There are mosquitoes around.
Oh, no.
Do you want to put it?
Well, the one I couldn't. Where did you put it? Where is my warm top?
I don't know, but just.
There are a lot of these ants here. Yeah, I'm listening.
I'm getting a press guy to come out to spray for ants and spiders.
Okay.
Because I do not want those on our property.
7 acres of land is going to be sprayed.
No, we've given those pooping machines a lot of pellets. They've made new pellets.
you know. Look, he's going to put his head through the barbed wire. I don't want him to do it. It's okay, darling.
It's okay.
It's okay. Come over here, darling. Come over here, darling. It's all right. It's all right.
I don't want him to eat my finger. He's always pooing.
Come over here. Don't have any.
Okay, let's go. Let's explore.
Do you see how they're more interested in us now?
Yeah, I'm going to literally run out of space.
Won't this be a Let's Explore Tasmania?
No, there will be a Let's Explore Tasmania one day.
But you got to walk here. You got to get to here by walking.
No.
And swimming.
No, it will. But once we live here, I'll start a Let's Explore nearby.
A shared driveway. To the property next door.
Oh my gosh, that looks like a cow just sitting there.
Yeah, and it looks like a cow just sitting there with a white
hat. White, yeah.
But it's a rusty bathtub.
Oh, those are weird creatures. What are those strange creatures? So many strange creatures.
See, look at that. There it is. There's the sheep.
They're always eating. Every moment of every day.
Maybe that's why they poop so much.
Exactly. We've seen it. Let's keep going.
Okay, that driveway here.
I think
So we can't go over there.
It's the biggest and chunkiest.
No, that's
so where is our area?
Okay. This is the fence dividing.
Oh, okay.
It's the chunkiest.
It's just a bullet.
But are you sure they're not the killer ants?
No, they're not. Can I just say something? I used to see them when I went bushwalking in Lane Cove.
Okay, let's go through here.
Start here. Because this is the border.
Yeah.
This is the border.
Okay, so let's go in.
I think we just have to step over it.
No.
Is there a gate?
Look, this is a gate. See, I'm not a farmy, but I know how it works.
That's a gate.
What do you think this is?
I don't know. I thought
it's to keep animals out.
I thought you'd just step over it.
Can it start?
It's not really that cold. I'm just wearing this because of the mosquitoes.
Me too.
I mean, me free.
Okay.
That icon. Look at that icon.
Bill?
There's that icon.
Okay, come on.
What's it called again, Dad? The boiling pot.
Did you actually, can you go and put that? This is the perimeter between our property and the neighbours, 236. Yeah.
How many floors are there?
Oh, see this? This really needs chopping there. You can see where
the
ride
I couldn't get the ride in. I couldn't get it. See, you can't get out under the trees.
No, you can't get under the branch. Can you see where it's driven?
Yeah.
You can see, look, you can see that it's driven around.
Yeah, it obviously can't get under the trees.
How are you going to get those?
You'd have to buy a whippersnipper to do that. That would take ages.
Okay.
Just listen to all the insects and birds.
So, dragonfly, just, look.
Yep.
Let's seriously just be quiet for a second.
Okay.
And just listen to the sounds of nature.
I don't like that sound.
But you can just hear constant birds. And I bet when we discover them damned hard up there, we'll hear frogs.
You know what would have been what would have gone viral? Let's be silent for a minute and just listen to the sounds of nature, and then one of you guys does a massive fart.
Shh, we don't say that on video. That's why we really need to get a whippersnipper and get rid of that.
Whippersnipper.
You know what I'd like to do? I would like to get a white fence along this.
Those sorts of fences require constant maintenance, and you've got to treat them for rot and prime them, to paint them and sand them.
I'll do that.
That's why no, you won't. How many kilometres, like there's hundreds and hundreds of metres of fence.
I've got a lot of spare time.
No, you're going to spend your whole life maintaining. Those fences are constant maintenance.
Replace it every 10 years.
They use this fence because it's the lowest maintenance fence you can use. They're posts and steel. You don't have to do anything to them. Just replace the posts and stuff.
That's just a sparrow.
No. Was it?
It was just a sparrow.
Oh, looked a bit more exotic than that.
Yeah, remember when I was in kindergarten, I sat on a bull ant nest and they all went up my legs and were in my pants and they were biting me in there. And the teachers had to pull my pants down and whack them all off.
Can I say, you're still alive?
That's why every time I sit, I never sit on grass. I never sit on grass anymore.
Wait, you can sit anywhere. Well, I'm allowed to sit anywhere.
You can see where the ride on mower ends.
It's more than 10 degrees.
Yeah, but you know something?
You've actually got to do it up and down. You can't go this way, you've got to go up and down.
Oh, so is this kind of the border here? Is that the border or not? This? Is this border?
No, the fence.
Oh, okay.
This is just not cut.
Why did he not cut it?
You can't, because the mow will fall down.
That is more than bull ants. That's like a massive, the Norton obese snake. I'm going.
Oh, no.
I'm going.
An obese snake.
All the birds are down here. Jazzy, are you going to stay with us?
Been eating humans. That's why I'm scared of it.
No, well, the vendors are still alive. They've been here for 10 years. That was a mosquito.
Wait. Dad found a wolf. That's not a walking stick.
It's a spear.
Dad found...
I'm an aboriginal.
Oh, wait a sec.
No.
Wait a sec.
I better not say that. You almost poked her in the face. You almost poked her in the face. Didn't you? Tilted. It didn't look like you almost poked her in the face. Careful, you're going to kill someone else.
The reason you can't say that is because it's tokenistic.
Can you just proceed? Yep. Just film down around here because we have...
My band is getting old.
That's what they do, they get old.
That's why I hate Band-Aids.
It's noisy, but because the mosquitoes are...
Are you trying to make it go down? Okay, so outside...
There's an icon.
Well, it's flashing. That lighthouse actually flashes. If you take a look at it, which you can't even see... It's so dark outside compared to what we're used to. See, it's so dark. You can see lights in the distance. Like, way out at Kingston over there and... across the other island on the other side, but you can't see much because it's blurry. The autofocus doesn't work.
Your knees are in the way.
But yeah, and that icon out there, that iron pot lighthouse or whatever it's called, it flashes. There it goes.
Amazing.
Yeah, and we're about to watch a movie now on the laptop.
Are all the doors closed, Bench?
Yep.
Okay, see ya. Okay, so here is the places. Heat pump. They don't actually call these air conditioners here.
There's heat coming out. It's obviously just started. It's not going to be very hot.
It's only very slight, just like the other one. But they call them heat pumps here. And look,
I'm seeing a reading for the
actual. You can kind of see a few lights out there.
26. I put it on 26.
Where does it say that? There's no display there.
Isn't that funny? They call them heat pumps here because you don't really need air conditioners in summer.